Welcome back to another edition of Max and Nikki 1,000 Time Reactions,
where we react to a song after listening to it for our 1,000th time.
We release 3 videos a day.
Every day.
So make sure to hit that subscribe button.
And ding that post notification bell.
So you don't miss out on all our content. What are we going to listen to right now, Max?
We're going to listen to And I Love Her by The Beatles.
In the running for maybe my favorite Beatles song of all time. Could be.
Wow, that's
could
a,
be.
Okay.
It's a very good
It's a very good song. If you're new to the channel, what we'd like to do here is listen to the song all the way through without stopping so as not to disrupt the intention of the artist. And then we'll talk about our reactions, go into some in-depth analysis, and talk about a little bit of the history of the song and the artist, if we should know anything about it.
And we certainly know a lot about the Beatles.
Sure.
But we also want to mention that we have another YouTube channel called Max and Nikki, on which we perform oldies tunes, including this song in particular, jazz standards and originals in that vein.
We got comedy videos on there as well.
In fact, we do perform a cover of And I Love Her, and you can check out our video of that in the description below. We'll put the link there so you can check out our cover of And I Love Her,
if you wish to do so. Mm-hmm. But for right now, let's take a listen to the Beatles, not cover, but the original version of And I Love Her
for our 1,000th time.
That's right. Here we go.
I give her all my love, that's all I do. And if you saw my love, you'd love her too. I love her. She gives me everything and tenderly. The kiss my lover brings, she brings to me. And I love her. A love like ours could never die, as long as I have you near me. Bright are the stars that shine, dark is the sky. I know this love of mine will never die. Bright are the stars that shine, dark is the sky. I know this love of mine will never die. And I love her.
Tell me why you got,
which is the next song on the album. This is, of course, on A Hard Day's Night. Great tune. A neat tune too. I mean, for, you know, was considered kind of a rock and roll band. You know, it's this laid back tune that
ballad.
You know, has this ballad, but it has
kind of
this kind of
smash Spanish-y kind of style to it.
Has a what?
Spanish-y kind of style to the song.
Yes. Yes, sort of that kind of a vibe, but I'm kind of thinking more something like, you might associate this song with like a beatnik type of vibe, you know,
because
the bongos in the background.
Well,
and it has this kind of, you know, mellowed out kind of sound.
I got to mention something real quick. I've been singing one lyric incorrectly, one word
All these years. We'll never die.
I always said, we'll never die. We'll never die. But it's
we'll
could
never
it's,
die.
We'll never die. But it's could never die, he says.
Right.
I did not know that.
Weird and wild stuff. Well, I'll tell you what's weird and wild stuff, actually, is on the final verse of the first time he sings it before the solo, he goes, bright, bright are the stars that shine. He's doubling his vocals for the most part.
For most of the song.
On that part, though, the first section, bright are the stars that shine, dark
it's
is
single.
The sky.
Single track.
I know this. And it's single. He's just, it's alone. But then he's introduced to the doubling of the vocals. I think it goes, again. Bright are the stars that shine, dark is the sky. I know this love of mine. It doubles it there at that point. Yeah. And then the second time that lyric comes around after the solo, it's doubled. Why did they do it? That's so interesting. Why they decided to do that.
It works, though. It works.
It does, but it's very interesting.
Well,
weird and wild stuff.
A little history lesson here. George Harrison is actually the one who came up with... Dun, 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 dun.
That's right. Dun, he did dun, come dun, with... Dun.
And Paul just thought, wow, that just added... such a memorable element to the song
it's
that he didn't think of
such a simple little riff, and yet it's
because obviously
memorable.
We know that Paul wrote this song, if you weren't aware of that.
Actually, if you hear the bass isn't really doing too much on this, but it's
that's
doing
some,
just,
that's something I,
that's doing, it's doing what is needed.
That's something I noticed kind of halfway through the song. I was like, oh, there's a bass going on mm-hmm. in this song. I wasn't even paying attention to that, you know?
I also, you know, you have that, what are those?
Clave?
Yeah, the clave, you know, that's kind of as a night.
It's more like cool. Higher. Like that, you know.
Anyway, it's a cool addition to the song. It's,
sure.
It's some, that's what's cool about this song. It's simple, and the added elements of something that's maybe not as usual to a pop song.
Two acoustic guitars.
And it's a simple addition to it, adds so much.
Two acoustic guitars going on.
Two acoustic guitars. One is the rhythm, and obviously the other one's the
but
lead.
I'm a little... Well, you know, George, he does first does dun 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 dun, but then he starts... He does these arpeggios. And I'm not sure... What does John add to the song? What is he... Is he playing
he's playing rhythm guitar.
Are you sure?
I'm not totally sure.
Are you sure that's not just Paul?
Well, I'm
are you sure that's not just Paul?
You're doing a little overdoing
sure.
it.
Are you sure that's not just Paul?
Are you sure it's not just Paul?
Are you sure that's not Paul?
Well, let me see. You know, I can
Stones
take a real quick
sort of
look
a blues
right here.
Cover band, you know.
Well, it says here personnel. That's right. See, Paul McCartney vocals, bass guitar, John Lennon acoustic, rhythm guitar, George Harrison classical lead guitar, classical.
Well, I suppose John would be playing
that makes sense.
The rhythm guitar.
John is playing a rhythm acoustic guitar, but it sounds like a steel string, actually. You know, it sounds like a steel string.
I didn't think so.
Well, I do. I think so. And Ringo Starr is playing both the bongos and the claves.
Yeah, there you go.
Yeah, there you go.
Just wanted to inject this here. We also, it's really interesting that he says, and I love her, as opposed to just, I love her. And I was listening to an interview with Paul talking about it. And to be honest, he's not really clear what he's saying. He just thought, you know, I just thought, you know, why not? And I love her. You know, he just says something like that. That's just, it's kind of a basic explanation that there's no real true reason. But it's...
Well, it is an interesting addition. Instead of just saying, I love her, he's saying, and I love her. As though, let's see, how do the lyrics go?
I give her all my love. That's all I do. And if you saw my love, you'd love her too. Oh, the first verse is, and he just says, I love her. But then,
right.
But which makes sense according to the grammar. But then he says, she gives me everything and tenderly. The kiss
my lover brings,
she brings to me, and I love her. Almost like it's an afterthought.
Well, no, but it's almost saying, well, because she's giving him all these things in that line.
All right.
You know? How does it go again? It goes,
She gives me everything and tenderly.
The kiss my lover brings, she brings to me.
And I love her, like, and I reciprocate that.
Yeah. Well, no, or it's also saying, she's doing all these things for me, and it makes me feel good, I guess. And you know, on top of that, I love her too.
Or more, it's like, the kiss my lover brings, she brings to me, and thus I love her. Like, thus I love her.
I don't like and that. I love her. I don't like that as an interpretation because it's making it seem like, oh, I love her because she does stuff for me. I don't know. That just kind of, I'm not.
But then the last one, bright are the stars that shine, dark is the sky. What is he trying to say there? Bright are the stars that shine, dark is the sky. I know this love of mine will never die, and I love her.
I know this love of mine will never die, and I love her. I mean, okay.
It's almost like a poem where...
Well, no, I'm just
he repeats this sort of refrain as if it's a poetry, you know?
Yeah, bright are the stars that shine, dark is the sky. It's almost maybe it's a little bit of a sophomore attempt at being poetic. What do you think?
Bright are the stars that shine, dark is the sky. I know this love of mine will never die.
Unless it's nighttime. Just, I mean, let me...
No, listen, think about it. It's nighttime.
Let me just say, let me take that back, what I said about it being sophomoric. I think maybe it's, he's looking at the, you know, they're looking at the stars together. They're having a romantic time.
No.
And, you know, he's thinking, this will never die, you know?
That's not what I'm thinking.
And guess what? And I love her. It's just, it's a refrain. Sure. And I love her. It's just a repetition.
It could be that. But here's another interpretation. It is more poetry. Bright are the stars that shine, dark is the sky. Almost as if this is the end of his life with this person. Bright are the stars that shine, dark is the sky. It's nighttime. I know this love of mine will never die. Meaning even by the end of their lives, in the nighttime, in the twilight years of their lives, my love will still not die, even as we get older, and I love her, which is still the refrain. Uh-huh, get it? Uh-huh. How do you feel about that, Max, for an interpretation?
But why? Okay.
Good job, Nikki, with the analysis.
It could be. And then, and I love her. It's like this, it's this almost a mantra, actually, in a way. And I love her. It's like he's, and the, having that, I mean, this is before they got into, you know, Buddhism and everything, but it does have this quality, this kind of, this calming quality, this
meditative
song.
Quality.
Meditative quality, and I love her. It's almost, yeah, this refrain that one keeps repeating. It's almost like...
I would definitely take that back if I were you about it being sophomore.
I said I'd take it back.
And I say you should definitely take it back.
And I said
I think it's quite poetic. I think it's good. That's a good lyric at the end there.
Sure.
If you interpret it the way I am, where he's talking about the twilight years, bright are the stars that shine, dark is the sky... I know this love of mine will never die, even in our old age.
I'm not thinking of it like that. And I love her. I don't personally think. I think of it more just as...
Do you not accept my interpretation, though? I think it's a good interpretation.
I'm saying it can be interpreted that way. I don't interpret it that
way. But you don't think it's a good interpretation?
I think it's a fine interpretation.
Oh, I think it's a great interpretation.
I think it's just a fine interpretation, Nikki.
I think it's a great interpretation.
But I think... I think of it like, you know, they're in this moment, and he just... and it's... There's something... pure about this. The dark is the sky and the lights can be the stars, you know, in stark contrast, the lights are shining bright against this dark sky, and there's something unadulterated about it. You're not getting any of the, you know, it's just those things, and he's clear of thought, and he's thinking, this is a nice time to be with my love together, and there's nothing else, and he's just and I love her, you know. Something like that.
I like my interpretation more. Hey, why don't you tell us how you interpret the lyrics in the comments below? Maybe share whose interpretation you prefer, mine or Max's. I like mine, obviously. He likes his. I think his is valid, but I think I have a stronger argument.
That's valid. Here. It's valid.
Let us know what you think in the comments. It's a great tune, man.
It's a great tune, man. It's very groovy.
You know, I just, gosh, I love this song, you know?
It's also simple. The lyrics are you know, it has a simple quality, but yet poetic, you know? I think that it's a real cool thing.
Yeah. Hey, you know, what can else? Sorry, I keep saying, you know, but what else can you say? But just, it's great.
Yeah. Well, anyway, I think that'll probably do it for this reaction video.
Remember, if you want to check out our cover of this, we'll put the link to that in the description below. And make sure to hit that subscribe button and ding that post notification bell to find out about more Max Nicky reaction videos. Please keep tuning in.